Touch somebody next to you and say to them, you made it. Amen. Amen. That's right. You made it. You made it. You made it. You know, one of the things I've discovered about God is that God sometimes speaks, peace be still, and calms the storm. And then there are times that God speaks to us and calms us. I want you to let that soak real deep in. Because as Sunil was speaking and talking about the woman who felt that she was not getting her prayers through, and I guess that's all of us sometime or the other, that we feel that we are not having our prayers come through. But I've discovered that sometimes, even though our prayers don't come through, God knows how to keep us calm, to wait. We have to always remember that God is sovereign. God is sovereign, and that's a big word to some people, but you along in the church would know that all sovereign means is that God does what he wants on his own time. He does what he wants on his own time. You would want to think that these Hebrew boys, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, these Hebrew boys, they were praying to God. They were so committed to God. They were so devout. Man, even when they were asked to eat of the king's food, which to them was going to be contaminating their bodies, and it would be going contrary to their strict Jewish customs. These precious boys, these young men, they decided that they were not going to, amen, contaminate themselves with the king's meat and defy their bodies, defy their customs, because they wanted to please Jehovah God. And they fasted, and the word of God said that when the king came and he was looking for people to put into his kingdom as leaders over his subjects, he chose these three young men, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. Why he chose them, the scripture said, is because they looked better than the others. Sometimes when you endure testings, when you endure trials, the devil has a way to play with your mind. Play with your mind and tell you, look at you, look at you. Look at how you're looking. Look at how, amen, you are having to go through your testings and your trials. Look at you. The devil comes to tell you that. And oftentimes some people buy it and they find themselves compromising their faith. And now self, they begin to look bad. Because oftentimes when they are saying, the devil is saying, look at you, you don't know how good you are looking in the eyes of God, because God is able to keep that which you have committed to him. Whatever you have committed to God as it relates to walking with God, God will stand with you. If you could never, let me say it this way, you can never give God one and God didn't give you two. God will always give you more than you can ask or think. I think somebody needs to give God a praise in this house right now. Amen. God will always give you more than you can ask or think. But you see, you cannot believe the devil's lie. Take somebody next to you and say, don't believe the devil's lie. Because God may not always still the storms in the midst of you. Amen. But God can take you through the storms. You ask Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. Amen. They met another trial in their life. They met another turbulent situation in their lives. But you know one of the things that these three young men always did? They always made godly choices. They always make godly choices. Touch somebody next to you and say, examine your choices. Amen, amen. Somebody on the other side, examine your choices. You as a child of God, amen, I want you to know that God would always stand with you. You need to examine your choices, because God, amen, sometimes he allows certain things in our lives. God allows it. Let me tell you this. You cannot always choose what you go through. Amen. You cannot always choose what you go through. Amen. Or even why you go through it. You don't get answers at times to why you are going through what you are going through. You don't always get answers to it. But hear me today. I want you to know that you can make choices still. You can make choices. The reason why you should make choices, it is because you do not chance your destiny. No one should be chancing their destiny. Don't you ever, no matter, amen, which Obia man come and tell you, amen, just wait, amen, just wait, amen, amen. You live and you live aimlessly, because the, amen, the fact remains that if you keep aiming, or if you keep shooting at nothing, you're going to get the results. You're going to get nothing. And I know some people try to play smart in that they really are not shooting at anything. They're living aimlessly. But when they hit something, they say, this is what I was aiming at. I want you to know, amen, there is always, amen, on the target, a bullseye. And you always, amen, feel, amen, a sense of achievement when you hit bullseye. And you know when you hit bullseye. Amen. And you got to keep aiming. That's why, amen, destiny is not a matter of chance. Destiny is a matter of choice. You have to choose your destiny. You have to make up in your mind that I know what I want. Come on. You got, amen. If you don't know what you want, you better today start knowing what you want. Amen. You got, don't let nobody tell you what you should want, because they will give you what they think you want. That's why I love John the Baptist. Amen. John the Baptist, amen, when they came to him and they said to him, are you Elijah? Or are you Jeremiah? Or are you one of the prophets? Jeremiah, amen, John the Baptist must have asked Elijah. He must have asked, well, which one of the prophets? Now, it always somehow looks good for when people, amen, can put you with good stuff. Amen. But you just don't want to be collected with good stuff and get lost, amen, in the good stuff. Because, listen to me, there is nothing as good as an original. Amen. There is nothing as good as an original. Amen. And you don't want to be a carbon copy. You don't want to be just trying to be like somebody else. There is nothing as nice when you put on a shoes and you don't feel your toes bundle up in front of it. Or you put on a shoes and my goodness, when you walk in it, it burning the back of your heel. Amen. Amen. And you ladies, amen, you are terror for pain in many instances. Amen. You go to work with two shoes, one under the table, amen, and one on your foot, and sometimes one in the car, amen, and one, amen, in the back seat, amen. And you know you're uncomfortable, but you don't mind. Beauty with pain, amen. That's what you call it, beauty with pain. But oh my goodness, amen, there is nothing when you get a good fit, amen, because it's just for you. It's just good feeling like it's good for you. You must be always good for yourself and let nobody else, amen, try to make you feel good. Come on and give God a praise in this place here today. You gotta be good for yourself. So John the Baptist said, I know who I am. I am a voice. That's what John said. John said, I am a voice. That's who I am. You can say what you want. You can call me whatsoever you want. But I'm a voice. I know my assignment. I know my assignment. As I was saying, in life, we have to make choices. And as I was also indicating that we don't choose the stuff that comes our way. As Nicola was referencing, you know, sometimes we have bad days. Amen. Disappointments. Amen. Financial trials and financial testings. We don't want to choose these things, but amen, life meets us, amen, at different points in the journey, and we face these different things. Bad relationships. Oh, amen, with a spouse or with a friend or even with, amen, a relationship you're trying to develop. And amen, you meet some scallywag, you know, who just, amen, just turn up to be a pain in the head. Oh, amen, a pain in the head, amen, amen. You just, amen, you wish you could just blink your eyes like amen, like Bewitched, amen. Amen, and just disappear. Amen, but yeah, amen, amen. By the way, there ain't no good witch, so don't even blink your eyes. Amen, keep your eyes open. You need to go through it. Amen, amen, amen. The harder they come, you got to tell yourself, the harder they will fall. Amen, you got to just keep going and make up your mind that you are getting out of this situation. In spite of, you have to keep telling yourself that you are getting out of this situation. Now it is important that you, amen, set yourself to live as an overcomer. You have to set yourself to live as an overcomer. Now you may not have chosen what is happening to you, but there are certain things that you can choose in spite of what is happening to you. And one of the things I would like to recommend that you choose, amen, today is to choose Philippians chapter 4 and verse 8. In Philippians chapter 4 and verse 8, the word of God says, finally, brethren, whatever things are true and whatever things are noble and whatever things are just and whatever things are pure and whatever things are lovely and whatever things are of a good report, if there be any virtue and if it be praiseworthy, think on these things. That's right. You see, because people, amen, can bring things to you to mess you up. And not only sometimes people, but when you're going through the darkest lane in your life, you're going through the darkest lane. When you are having to run sometimes to finish the race, and you're ready and truly, you're wanting to stop, because there are times in the journey of life when you are facing your struggles and your trials, you want to really stop, you know. You really wish it could just stop. Amen. Am I talking the truth here today? You wish it could stop. And this is when you need to choose. Amen. You need to choose these things. Amen. You need to choose it. You need, amen. You need to realize, listen, I got to be honest with myself. Amen. I got to handle this thing in a just way. I got to handle it in a just way. In the midst of all I'm going through, I'm going to still stay pure. Amen. I'm going to walk with God through this. Somebody help me here. Amen. Amen. I am going to stay lovely. Amen. I'm going to stay lovely. I'm going to make myself up. I'm going to have a nice attitude. Amen. Don't let nobody change your attitude. Remember, as it is said, your attitude determines your altitude. Amen. Don't let nobody rob you of your attitude. Sometimes some people come by, amen, and oh my God, they're like stinky poops, you know. Amen. They come by and they can mess you up and, amen, cause you to turn up your face and turn up your spirit, leave with a messed up spirit, amen. But no, amen, I'm gonna rise above it. Somebody say, rise above it. I am going to rise above it. I'm gonna remain lovely. Amen. I'm gonna remain lovely, because sometimes it's amazing, God tests us. Amen. With the unlovely and the unlovable. God tests us with them. But we got to remain with that attitude. We got to, amen, remain with that good attitude. Amen. And recognize that whatsoever things of a good report, please look, keep looking for good reports. Amen. Don't let the devil tell you that all is bad, because the God that you serve is a delivering God. I hear Paul saying he is able to take the trial. He is able to work with the trial. My God is able to work with the trial. And he's not only just able to work with the trial, but he's able to bring glory out of us in every trial. He's able to bring glory out of us. Amen. That's why the word of God said, and I've been quoting it quite frequently recently, that God prepares a table in the presence of our enemies. There are some people, oh my God, amen, they are just to stay there, amen, so God can, amen, show them that he's preparing a table for you, that he's going to bring you out, that, amen, that you're going to come through this, that you are going to make it. Touch somebody next to you and say, I'm going to make it. I am going to make it. I am going to make it. Yes, you are going to make it. Hallelujah. Because God sees in you, God sees in you a victorious end. Always remember that. God sees in me a victorious end. Just put your hand on your breast and say with me, God sees in me a victorious end. Amen. I want you to know that, because your God is omnipotent. Your God is omnipotent. Your God is all powerful. Your God is the El Shaddai. Your God is the Almighty. mighty God. Your God is not some mighty. Your God is almighty. Come on and put your hands together and give the all. Come on and put it together. Your God is the almighty God. Amen. He said to Pharaoh, he said, I will provoke you until you do what you can do, until you set up yourself. And when Pharaoh did all he could have done in hardening his heart, God took him down to the Red Sea and God showed him a highway. Amen. And he saw Israel going through, amen, the Red Sea as an highway. And little did Pharaoh know that God was setting it up, amen, to make a watery grave out of all his horsemen and his chariots, in so much that when Miriam got on the other side, she got the women ministry together and they began to put their hands to in praise and worship with the tambourine in hand and sang the praises of God and declared that God is a delivering God. I want you to know today that your God, he knows how to keep you in the midst of every trial, in the midst of every test. Amen. All you have to do is to choose God. Make smart choices. You have to make smart choices. The reason why you have to keep making choices, because in life, according to Romans chapter 8 and verse 35, sometimes we face distress. We face persecution. Sometimes leanness. You want to know, my goodness, like it's a drought in my life. I ain't getting through with nothing. Amen. Farming. We face droughts in our lives. Sometimes nakedness. Amen. You just feel so undecorated. You don't feel yourself. You don't feel yourself. Nakedness. You feel so ashamed sometimes. It happens to the best of us. Oh my God, what am I in? It happens to the best of us. Oh yes, sometimes for some of us it gets worse and worse and worse and wassera. It really gets bad. Amen. It happens to the best of us. Oh, yes, the perils come. Oh, you thought, amen, that growing up would have made it so easy. And then you realize growing up, it's another pain. Yeah. Amen. Growing up is another pain because you have so many choices to make. Amen. And you have to deal with so much. Amen. You have to deal with so much. You have to keep facing. Sometimes it's sword. Amen. Somebody want to fight you. You're facing sword. Oh, my God. Them demons just come and harass these people to harass you. Amen. And like me, sometimes when you know you could beat them, it becomes even more frustrating. Amen. Because, amen, you know you could cuss them better than they could cuss you. Amen. It's just that you traded your cuss for Christ. Amen. Amen. You know I'm talking the truth sometimes. Amen. But they, amen, the sword. But you know one of the things that you need to choose? You can choose. In spite of what they are offering you, you can choose, amen, to receive the fact that in spite of what you are going through, nobody could stop God from loving you. Hallelujah. In spite of what you are going through, let me say it again, nobody can stop God God from loving you. In spite of what you're going through, you know that you have the love of. I wish you could just hold on, hold God. Just feel like you're holding God and just rock your shoulder. Come on, stand on your feet a little bit. Amen. And just feel that you, amen, the God that you serve is wrapping you up in his arms. Come on, the God that you serve is wrapping you up. Oh, I know God loves me. God loves me. And nobody can stop God from loving me. I know that God loves me. And because God loves me, he's going to take care of me. Hallelujah. Amen. That my God shall supply all my needs according to his riches and glory by Christ. Come on and give God a praise. Lift up your voice in this place here today and give God a praise. Oh, come on and praise him, church. Hallelujah. 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 I can do all things. Have you seats? I can do all things through Christ. Oh, who strengthens me. So in spite of what you face, in spite of what you face, your Jesus Christ, amen, has promised to you, even though you feel like you're killed, even though you feel like you're like a sheep before its shearers, amen, I want you to know, amen, that God will never, never, never give up on you. He promises to be with you always, even as unto the ends of the earth. He promises to be with you. He is going to be with you. A young man came to me, amen, on last week and became so frustrated and told me, he said, you know, the my work is calling me on this week to let me know that I am going to be here for the last week. I said to the young man, I said, young man, don't think on the negative. Think on the positive side of it. I said, God may just be putting you through a test for you to, amen, to trust him. Amen, and to know him in a better way because you have purpose in your life. God will not put you on the streets just like that. Amen. The young man spoke to me again today, and he said to me, he said, Pastor, he said, I went to work, and you know when they called me, what they told me? They're giving me 6 more months. They said they're giving me 6 more months. Listen to me, I want you to know, sometimes you feel that you are on your end, but God, amen, never leaves you, amen, for the enemy to rejoice over you. Amen, I want you to know, as the word of God says, amen, that you are more than conquerors. According to Romans 8:37, that you are more than conquerors through him that loves you. God loves you. God is going to put a conqueror's spirit inside of you. You are going to conquer. Oh, just raise your hand and feel that conqueror's anointing coming upon you, because God loves you. He is going to make you a conqueror. Come on and stand again and begin to give God another praise. You need to give him a bigger praise this time, because you are a conqueror. There is a grace coming upon you. There is a strength coming upon you. Amen. A power from God coming upon you to live as an overcomer. Somebody need to shout, yes! Come on and keep worshiping him. Keep worshiping him. Keep magnifying him. Keep magnifying him. Because you are a conqueror.
Your God didn't bring you this far to leave you alone. Just high five somebody and tell them that. And God did not bring you this far to leave you alone. Amen. He did not bring you this far. Turn around and meet somebody behind you and encourage somebody on the other side and tell them that God didn't bring you this far to leave you alone. God is my helper. Hallelujah. I shall not fear what man can do. Hallelujah. God is going to help you. God is going to bring you through. God is going to take care of you. Amen. I wish I had some crazy people to keep worshiping God and praising God. Hallelujah. Keep worshiping God and praising God. I want you to check out. Watch at verse 38. Watch at verse 38. The Apostle Paul says, I am persuaded that neither death nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor powers, nor things present, nor things to come, shall be able to separate me from the love of God, which is in Christ Jesus. I got news for you today. Choose Jesus. As long as you choose Jesus, nothing will be able to separate you. You are going through, but you're coming out. Somebody say, I'm going through, but I'm coming out. Give God praise in this place. Give God praise in this place. You are going through, but you're coming out. You're coming out. You're coming out like dry gold. Hallelujah. You're coming out like dry gold. I wish somebody could just run through this place and say, by my God, I ran through a troop. By my God, I leap over a wall. Your God is bringing you out in spite of what the devil tries to do to you. Your God is, I wish I had somebody to really give God a crazy praise in this place. Hallelujah. I wish I had some people who would just put on a dance right now and say, this one is for God. 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 This one. This one is for God. Come on and give him a praise. You need to take your eyes off of whoever you're looking at and look as unto the Lord. From whence cometh your help? Your help comes from the Lord. Come on and give him a crazy praise. Deliverance until you start doing something about your present circumstance. Oh, do something about your present circumstance. Thank you.
all things through Christ. Yes, you can. Yes, you can. Yes, you can. Hallelujah. You can do it. Yes, you can. Hallelujah. Yes, you can. Yes, you can. Yes, you can. Yes, you can. You can. You can. You can do all things through Christ who strengthens you. Yes, you can. You can do all things. The devil is a liar. Oh, just high five somebody next to you and say, amen. Yes, you can. Amen. You need just to take a turn around by faith right now and say, better things are coming my way right now. There's a turning around. There's a turnaround. Yes, you can. Yes, you can. There's a turning around. Come on, put those hands together. Put it together. Oh, we're gonna sing. Come on. Yes, you can. You choose to. You choose to. You can do all things through Christ who strengthens you. You gotta be persuaded that nothing the devil brings is gonna take you down. You're an overcomer. The horns of the altar and
leave it there. Just leave it there. Come on, bring it down. You feel something, just bring it down and say, spiritually, I'm leaving it right here in the altar. I'm going back home. I can. Come on, right there.
Oh, yeah. A simple song, simple melody. Yes. To remind you that you can be the greatest ever.
Just bring it, leave it on the altar.
Sometimes you may lose so much.
Yes, you can.
Yes, you can now.
You can do anything you can try. Just try.
Oh my.
Yes, you can.
Yes, you can now.
But you have to believe in rely on what
you have all down here. You have all down here. You have all down here. Come on. You have all down here. All down here. Baskets, we're going home now. We're going home.
Let the children sing.